Okay, so the next topic is morality. I've participated in a lot of Christian atheist debates, and it's very common now for Christian apologists to claim, apologists is a person who defends a faith, to claim that atheists, when they talk about morality, they're borrowing from the Christian worldview. They say Christian, they say atheists have no basis for morality. You know, like without God, you wouldn't have morality. Morality requires God. Atheists can be moral, but they don't really have a justification for it because basically you really have to believe in God in order to justify morality and what morality is and all that. So, what do you have to say about all that?
That I think about when I was a believer, I didn't want to murder, steal, or cheat. And ironically, to those who would say that, I don't have a desire to murder or steal or cheat now that I don't believe. I don't. The justification is you want to be a good person and you want to live right, or you should. And that you don't need a belief in divinity for that.
Well,
There's
I could see what the response to you is going to be is, well, you know, you were a Christian for a long time. It's just, you know, kind of a, you know, you absorbed all that, and so now as an atheist, you're living your Christian morals without knowing it.
Yeah, but ironically, I've heard people say the opposite of, they say that now that you are an atheist, you probably don't have the same morals you had when you were a believer. And I think, well, where does that come from? That doesn't make any sense at all.
Well, actually, there is some truth in that. I mean, like when I was a believer, I believed in, I mean, I believe there was an unhealthy attitude of self-sacrifice, basically. And now, as an atheist, a big part of my goal in life is to enjoy life. And I don't need to pour myself out as if there's going to be some kind of afterlife to enjoy later. I mean, this is it. So I still do good things, but I also do things in moderation and not to the extreme. For example, I know Christopher Hitchens said, you know, Mother Teresa was an evil person and wrote a book about it, and I haven't read it. But I can see it from the aspect that Mother Teresa devoted her entire life to the Catholic Church and to helping the poor and everything, to the point of where she didn't even have her own life. And you know, she even talks about how her struggles. She didn't know if even God was alive and all that or was real. But to me, I see that as an extreme. I mean, I think it's good to help, but not to go overboard on that. Do you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I think the issue you get into a lot with people who are believers is, and this is the way that I was, so I'm just speaking off of what I know and what I can say from my life. I would live right because I knew that if I didn't, it would upset God, and then there would be a judgment for that. So today, I still do what's right without that, without the sinners in the hands of an angry God mentality in my mind. So I think I don't want to say I'm better off today than I was, but I think you can see that I live and do what's right now because it's what's right, not because God's standing over me, ready to punish me if I do wrong. And so I think a lot of Christians, a lot of believers will say, I'm living right, I'm not breaking the Ten Commandments, I'm not doing anything that's wrong because I know that heaven is my reward. Well, what about just being good? What about the justification of just being a good person, of just knowing that you're doing what's right? And I think sometimes that's missed in the church.
Well, how do you know what's good? Like, for example, let's say you're not married, and a Christian would say, "Do not have premarital sex. That's a sin." Do you think it's a sin for people to have premarital sex, or do you think it's bad
Do
or
I think it is
immoral?
now?
Yeah, now, do you think it's bad or
No.
immoral?
No.
So the Christian might say, like, see, well, right there, you're not as moral as you were as a Christian.
Well, I would have to ask them then, why do they believe it? And what's interesting is the verses they're going to quote, I can think of a few of them off the bat, they're going to be taken out of context. And I don't debate. I'm not a debate. I don't like to do that because it always goes back to what we just said a few minutes ago. Every answer turns into it's a miracle, and so it's difficult to have a debate in that aspect. But when you're looking at, look, anything taken to the extreme, it can be bad. And that includes sex. It includes, for a lot of people, I mean, listen, a lot of Christians I know will tell you if you take things to the extreme, it's bad. And yet I know that when I was a Christian, one of the things that I took to the extreme was eating. And I was overweight. And so, it worked for me to eat what I wanted to, but I was against premarital sex because, well, it wasn't readily available anyways. So what I have is, it's oftentimes a convenience of, this is what I believe based upon what is convenient for me. Now,
Well, it could be readily available to you if you're looking for it. For example, if you went on a dating website or something, it probably really wouldn't be difficult to find somebody
well,
else
sure.
if you're actually looking for it.
Yeah, and we saw just a few weeks ago or a few months ago that some pastors were found out on Ashley Madison. They were out looking for it.
Well, I mean
So, I mean,
even
that's.
I mean even just regular dating sites though too.
Sure.
So
Yeah. I mean, anything in our world today, anything is there if you want it. But like, see, right now, I'm married. I have 5 children. I'm not going out dating. I'm not going out looking for something outside of my marriage, not because of, it's just because what I believe is right for me in my marriage today.
Right. Now,
Because
what if you met a couple that said, we have an open relationship, we believe that it's okay to have sex outside of a marriage, me and my spouse, it's fine with us. Would you say that's immoral, or do you think, what would you say about that?
well, in the past, I would have been quick to say that. Today, I don't argue that point anymore. I think a lot of times there are things that I would disagree with, but not it's not for a biblical reason. It's because I just, it doesn't work for me, so to speak. And is it healthy? I don't know. I've never lived that life, so I can't tell you.
So when you say it doesn't work for you, I think what you're trying to get at is basically you can foresee the consequences of that and you don't like the consequences that would result of that.
For me in my life, correct, yes.
So basically that goes to what they call consequentialism, but you basically know if something's right or wrong based on what you foresee as the consequences.
Right, and at the same time, I can't tell somebody what in their life is right or wrong, especially if I've never lived that life. Because it's the same reason why I, just my personal belief, I don't think men should say anything about abortion. I think that's for women. That's their bodies. It's for them to discuss and debate. And men should just keep our mouths shut and stay out of it because we're not open to have one. That's my personal view, my personal belief. It's definitely not going to be theologically correct, but
Well,
I
I think
believe
with
that.
abortion too, there's also it's very important to realize there's a gray area. For example, the extremes are, I think, are nonsense. For example, the Catholic extreme is they don't even use the birth control pill because they consider it abortion. So don't even do that. That's a sin, which I think is obviously, most people say that's obviously extreme. Then the other point is if somebody were to argue that abortion should always be legal, even up to 9 months right before the baby's delivered normally, if you can kill the baby, that's okay because it's an abortion. I think most people would say, well, obviously that's murder, that's wrong.
Right.
And I don't, doesn't matter if you're a male or a female, anybody should be able to say, that's gross, that's sickening, that's, you don't do that. And so the real difficult point is the somewhere in between there is where it's okay.
Yeah, well, you have a in this instance, you have a very large gray area when you're discussing something like that. And there's many things like that in this world today where it's, somebody wants a black and white answer, and you're going, well, wait a minute, there's more to it than what you're giving me. It's not just yes or no.
Yeah, my take on the morality is that, from a Christian standpoint, there's a lot of naivety. They don't realize that moral philosophy is very rich and in-depth. There's a lot there. And I after I be after I left Christianity and was an atheist, I started had to learn more about this just actually for the purpose of debates. And the way I developed the way I gave came up in summary is that morality is all about good and bad behavior. That's very important to realize. And so then the Christian will say, well, how do you know it's good and bad? And from my research, I came up with three criteria to determining. And the reason why there's three criteria is because some moral issues depend on one criterion and some a different one. And sometimes sometimes they conflict and you have to kind of struggle with yourself. But those three criteria are consequentialism, where you look at the consequences of an action. The other one is reciprocity, where you look, you know, you treat people as you want them to treat you. And the other one is individual rights. So basically the idea that you can do whatever you want to as long as you don't hurt anybody else. So some things, for example, like, is it okay to smoke marijuana? That's the kind of thing, well, you know, individual rights. And then something like, let's say, open marriage, that would be maybe heavily consequentialism and also individual rights. So those are the three, and the reason why I picked those three is because they all have to do with how it's going to impact society. And so for me, it's not that complicated, and this has nothing to do with God. I mean, the questions can be complicated because you got to look at those three criteria, but you can see it has nothing to do with it never comes into play, like, what would God say or what would God think? That just never comes in. So Christians have a hard time with this. It's like, well, how do you know it's right and wrong if there's no God? It's like, I don't borrow from the Christian theology at all. In fact, I would say Christian theology probably borrows from my belief because of consequentialism, for example. I think they rely on consequentialism without even knowing it.
Well, yeah, it's all... unfortunately, it's missing in the world today, but it's all common sense. And I like all three of those. I think they're all, at times, different points in our lives, important and definitely should be used to decide if something we're doing is right, if something we maybe shouldn't be doing at all.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so we're ready to move on to the next one?
Absolutely.